I worked in North Africa once, Mr. Hoppy said. That's where all the... In a couple of minutes, Mr. Hoppy was back on the balcony with a sheet of paper in his hand. I'm going to lower it to one of its strings, he said. Or it might blow away. Here it comes. Mrs. Silver caught the paper and held it up in front of her. This is what she read. Ezio Trot. Teg Regib. Emok No. Worg Poo. Fup Poo. Tooth Poo. Gnurps Poo. Wolb Poo. Luz Poo. Egrog. Elzug.
Futz.
Plug. Tup no taff, Ezio Trot. Tegno. Elbog. Doof. What does it mean? Is it another language? It's tortoise language, Mr. Hoppy said. Tortoises are very backward creatures. Therefore, they can only understand words that are written backwards. That's obvious, isn't it?
I suppose so.
Mrs. Silver said, bewildered. Ezio Trot is simply tortoise spelled backwards, Mr. Hoppy said.
Look at it.
So it is, Mrs. Silver said. The other words are spelled backwards too, Mr. Hoppy said. If you turn them round into human language, they simply say tortoise. Get bigger.
Come on, tortoise.
Grow up, puff up, shoot up.
Spring up.
Blow up.
Swell up.
Gorge. Guzzle. Stuff. Gulp. Put on fat, tortoise. Gobble food. Mrs. Silver examined the magic words on the paper more closely. I guess you're right, she said. How clever. There's an awful lot of poos in it. Are they something special? Poo is a very strong word in any language, Mr. Hoppy said. Especially with tortoises. Now, what you have to do, Mrs. Silver, is to hold Alfie up to your face and whisper these words to him three times a day. Morning, noon, and night. Let me hear you practice them. Very slowly, stumbling a little over the strange words, Mrs. Silver read the whole message out loud in tortoise language. Not bad, Mr. Hoppy said. But try to get a little more expression into it when you say it to Alfie. If you do it properly, I bet you anything you like that in a few months' time you'll be twice as big as he is now. I'll try it, Mrs. Silver said. Of course I will. But I can't believe it. You wait and see, Mr. Hoppy said.
Smiling later.
Back in his flat, Mr. Hoppy was simply quivering all over with excitement. Your slave for life, he kept repeating to himself. What bliss. But there was a lot of work to be done before that happened. The only furniture in Mr. Hoppy's small living room was a table and two chairs. These he moved into his bedroom and then he went out and bought a sheet of thick canvas and spread it over the entire living room floor to protect his carpet. Next, he got out the telephone book and wrote down the address of every pet shop in the city. There were 14 of them altogether. It took him two days to visit each pet shop and choose his tortoises. He wanted a great many, at least 100.
I like this language, tortoises. It's very slow.